In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet factoring trinomials where a is greater than 1. This is also known as factoring quadratic polynomials hard. And it's hard because that a is greater than 1. And what it means when it says that a is greater than 1, it is the formula ax squared plus bx plus c. This quadratic formula where this a is greater than 1. So our directions are to factor each completely. Now, factoring for when a was equal to 1, we would see what multiplied to give us c and added to give us b. However, since now we have an a involved, things are going to be slightly different. Our first step is to make sure this is in the correct order, ax squared plus bx plus c. After that, we're going to multiply our a, which is 3, to the c, which is negative 5. So 3 times negative 5 is going to give us negative 15. A times C equals 3 times negative 5, which is negative 15. Now we're going to find the factors of A times C that add to give us our B, which is negative 2. So the factors of 15 are 1 and 15, and then 3 and 5. So the number that's going to be negative in order to give us negative 2, will be the 5. 3 times negative 5 equals negative 15, and 3 minus 5 equals a negative 2. So now we're going to rewrite this polynomial as 3p squared plus 3p plus negative 5p, and then I'm going to subtract 5. So you can see that negative 2p, or subtracting 2p, is the same as 3p plus negative 5p. That is the negative 2p. So now what we're going to do is we're going to factor by grouping. So we're going to group the first two terms, and we're going to group the second two terms. And then we're going to factor out the greatest common factor from each binomial. So in this first binomial, we can pull out a 3p. So if we pull out a 3p, we'll get p plus 1. And that's because if we were to distribute that 3p back, we would get 3p times p, which is 3p squared, plus 3p times 1, which is 3p. And in this next binomial, we're going to factor out a negative 5. So if we pull out that negative 5, we'll be left with p plus 1. Since negative 5p divided by negative 5 is p, and when we're subtracting 5 and dividing that by negative 5, it's a positive 1. Essentially, the next step is that we're going to divide both of these parts by p plus 1. So essentially, we're pulling p plus 1 out of each of the terms. So now, instead of having 3p times p plus 1 plus negative 5 times p plus 1, we'll have 3p plus the negative 5, which we could also write as minus 5, times p plus 1. And that's because p plus 1 got multiplied to 3p, and p plus 1 also got multiplied to negative 5. So here we have 3p getting multiplied to p plus 1, and negative 5 getting multiplied to p plus 1. 3p minus 5 times p plus 1 is our solution in number 1. So going through the steps quickly again, multiply a to c and find the two numbers that multiply to give you a times c, but add to give you b. After that, group the first two terms and the second two terms together, then factor out the GCF, or the greatest common factor, and then you can factor out that common binomial. So number 2, let's write down our a, b, and c. A is equal to 2, b is equal to 3, and c is equal to negative 9. So we're going to multiply a times c, which is 2 times negative 9. And that's going to give us a negative 18. The factors of 18 are 1 and 18, 2 and 9, and then 3 and 6. So out of these factors, which ones will add to give us a positive 3? Well, since this is a negative 18, one of those is going to be negative. So that will be 3 and 6. If we add negative 3 to 6, we will get a positive 3. So now we're going to rewrite this polynomial splitting up this 3n. So it'll be 2n squared plus negative 3n plus 6n, since negative 3n plus 6n equals 3n. And then we're subtracting 9, which is the same as adding a negative 9 if you wanted to write it that way. Now let's group our terms, grouping the first two terms and the second two terms together. The only common factor in the first two terms is n. So I'm going to pull out n to get 2n plus negative 3, or I can write that as minus 3. And you can see if we were to distribute that n back, we'd get 2n squared minus 3n. And then the greatest common factor of 6n minus 9 is 3. So I'm going to pull out a 3, and I'll be left with 2n minus 3, since 3 times 2n is 6n, and 3 times 3 is 9. Now you can see that I have a common factor, 2n minus 3. So I'm going to factor out that binomial. So I'll have n plus 3 times 2n minus 3. You can see that n gets multiplied to 2n minus 3, and the 3 gets multiplied to 2n minus 3. And that's my solution in number 2. And note, since multiplication is commutative, we could also write this as 2n minus 3 times n plus 3. Either way is correct. Moving on to number 3, our a is 3, our b is negative 8, and our c is 4. So multiplying a to c, we'll multiply 3 to 4, and that will give us 12. So we need to find two numbers that multiply to give us 12, but add to give us negative 8. The factors of 12 are 1 and 12, 2, 6, and 3, and 4. Now this 12 is positive, but our b is negative, and a negative times a negative will equal a positive. If we multiply negative 2 to negative 6, we get a positive 12, and if we add those together, we'll get a negative 8. So we're splitting this 8n up as negative 2n and negative 6n. So we'll have 3n squared plus negative 2n plus negative 6n plus 4. Now I'm going to group my first two terms and my second two terms and factor out that GCF, the greatest common factor. In the first one, the greatest common factor is n. So factoring out n, I'll have 3n minus 2, or plus a negative 2. And in the second one, I'll factor out 2. However, as opposed to factoring out a positive 2, I'll factor out a negative 2. And in doing that, I'll get 3n minus 2. So I've factored out a negative 2 as opposed to a positive 2, so that I have 3n minus 2 and 3n minus 2, the same binomial. That way, I can factor out that binomial. So I'll take 3n minus 2, and that will be multiplied to n minus 2. And that's my solution in number 3. 3n minus 2 times n minus 2. And number 4, my a is 5, my b is 19, and my c is 12. Multiplying a and c together, I'll get 5 times 12, which is 60. So we need to find two numbers that multiply to give us 60 and add to give us a positive 19. The factors of 60 are 1 and 60, 2 and 30, 3 and 20, 4 and 15, and we can stop there because 4 plus 15 will give us 19. So I'm going to rewrite our polynomial as 5n squared plus 4n plus 15n plus 12, since 4n plus 15n equals 19n. Now I'm going to group the first two terms and the second two terms together and then factor out the greatest common factor of each. In the first one, our greatest common factor is n. So we'll have 5n plus 4. And in the second, our greatest common factor is 3. So we'll have 5n plus 4, since 3 times 5n is 15n and 3 times 4 is 12. Now, since I have two binomials that are the same, I can factor that out. So I'll have 5n plus 4 times n plus 3. And that's my solution in number 4. And number 5, my a is 2, my b is 11, MIC is 5. A times C is going to be 2 times 5, which is 10. My factors of 10 are 1 and 10 and 2 and 5. However, I need two numbers that add to give me 11, and 1 plus 10 equals 11. So I'm going to split this up as 2v squared plus 1v plus 10v plus 5, since 1v plus 10v equals 11v. Now, grouping the first two terms and the second two terms together, I'll factor out the GCF. In the first one, the greatest common factor is v. So I'll have 2v plus 1. In the second grouping, the greatest common factor is 5. 5 times 2v equals 10v, and 5 times 5, and 5 times 1 equals 5. So you can see, again, that I have a common binomial, 2v plus 1 and 2v plus 1. So I can factor out that binomial. That'll give me 2v plus 1 times v plus 5. 2v plus 1 times v plus 5 is my solution in number 5. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 6. However, before I go over the answer to this, please subscribe to my channel. All subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and let me know that you're finding these videos helpful, and they also let you know when I come out with new videos. So go ahead and do that now, and then we'll go over number 6. Our A in number 6 is 2, our B is 5, and our C is 2. Our first step, multiplying A to C. A times C is 2 times 2, which is going to give us 4. Now we're going to see what factors of 4 will add to give us 5. The factors of 4 are 1 and 4, and then 2 and 2. 1 plus 4 are the two factors that add to give us 5. So now we're going to rewrite this polynomial as 2n squared plus rewriting 5n as 1n plus 4n, and then we're still adding 2 at the end. Now I'm going to group the first two terms in this polynomial together and the second two terms together. 2n squared plus 1n, the greatest common factor, the GCF, is n. And if I were to take out an n from each of those terms, I would get 2n plus 1. In the second grouping, 2 is the greatest common factor, so if I were to take a 2 out, I would get 2n plus 1. And you can see n times 2n is 2n squared, n times 1 is 1n, 2 times 2n is 4n, and 2 times 1 is 2. Now that I have a common factor, I can factor out that binomial. So I'll have 2n plus 1 times n plus 2. 2n plus 1 times n plus 2. That is my solution in number 6. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, while you're at it, feel free to leave me a comment below and share this video if you know somebody else that would benefit from watching.